Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the ViewCharts component from SyncFusion. Imagine that you would like to analyze the monthly sales data of your company to determine your company's growth. Visualizing the data in a chart will let you understand it more quickly. So, in this video, I will show you how to visualize such sales data in a column chart using the ViewCharts component. There are over 30 SyncFusion chart types available to use in Vue, but I am going to use the column chart and show you how to enable a few of its basic features. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a Vue project using the Vue CLI tool, will edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and finally, view the output result on any of the supported browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code. I need to install the Vue CLI tool globally on my machine using the command npm install -g at vue/cli. As I have already installed it in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Then, I create a new Vue project using the command Vue create charts component. I named my project charts component. This will create an empty Vue application with no SyncFusion packages. I navigate to the newly created application folder. To start using the Vue charts component within this application, I need to install the charts package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2viewcharts --save. This command will install the charts plugin along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, my application is ready to use the charts component. The first thing I need to do here is register the chart plugin from the SyncFusion ViewCharts package. I open the app.vue file, import the chart plugin from the SyncFusion EJ2 ViewCharts package, and register the same plugin globally inside the API vue.use to register all child directives globally. To start using the charts component, within the template section, I define the EJS chart tag inside the division element. Next, I open the main.js file and import the register license from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the trial license key using the register license method. License key registration has been required for SyncFusion Vue components since the 2022 Volume 1 release. Okay, let me save the application and run it with the command npm run serve. This starts the development server and automatically reloads the page anytime I make edits to my project. Here, you can see the default chart output with two axes, X and Y, with no data points displayed. Next, I will show you how to populate data in the charts and display it as a column series. To render a column series chart, first, I need to define an eSeries collection tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of eSeries definitions inside it. I import the column series from the SyncFusion Vue charts package and inject it in the provide option. Then, I define a single eSeries tag with the type property and set its type to column to render the column series chart. Now, I populate the data for the column chart. As I am going to populate sales data in the chart, therefore, I create an object variable sales data and assign an array of objects with two fields named month and sales value within this data method. Then, I assign this object sales data to the datasource property and map the datasource fields month to the xname property and sales value to the yname property of the series. I am using categorized data for the x-axis, so I need to customize the x-axis value to category to display the month values in the chart. To use a category axis, first, I will import the category module from the SyncFusion EJ2 Vue charts package and inject it in the provide option. Then, I define the variable chart primary x-axis and set the value type property to category. Now, I assign this variable to the primary x-axis property. So now, you can see the column series chart displaying month values on the x-axis and sales data on the y-axis. Now, I am going to show you how to set the titles for the chart and axes. To set the title for the chart, I define the variable chart title and set the title to monthly sales analysis. Then, I assign this variable to the title property of the chart. As the x-axis depicts month values, I will set the x-axis title as months inside the chart primary x-axis variable. For the y-axis, I need to define a variable chart primary y-axis and set an appropriate title using title property, as the y-axis depicts sales values in dollars. Now, I assign this variable to the primary y-axis property. So here, you can see the view column chart displaying the main title, monthly sales analysis. You can also see that the x-axis shows the title as month and y-axis as sales in dollars. Now, let me show you how to add data labels to charts to display information about the data points. First, I import the data label module from the Syncfusion EJ2 view charts package and inject it in the provide option. Second, I define the variable chart marker and set the visible property to true. Then, I assign this variable to the marker property of the series. And now, you can see the column chart displaying data labels on each of its data points. Alright, now I am going to add a legend for the view chart. A legend gives more information about the series in the chart. To add a legend to the chart, I import the legend module from the Syncfusion EJ2 view charts package and inject it in the provide option. Next, I define the variable chart legend settings and set its visible property to true. I assign this variable to the legend settings property. I then set the chart series name to sales as a label for those legend items. You can see the chart displaying the legend, and you can collapse or expand the series of the chart by clicking on them. Okay, finally, I am going to show you how to make the view charts component more interactive by adding tooltips to it. First, I import the tooltip module from the Syncfusion EJ2 view charts package and inject it in the provide option. Then, I define the variable chart tooltip and enable the tooltip by defining the enable property as true. I assign this variable to the tooltip property. See in the output, the tooltip is shown for every data point of the chart. In this video, we have seen how to create a view project using Visual Studio Code and add a Syncfusion view charts component to it. We have also discussed how to render a column series chart with basic features. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire view component suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.